إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وبعد. All praise and thanks is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, none can misguide. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, لا يجد وليا ولا نصيرا. He will not get help whatsoever, and he will not get support whatsoever if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides. Now, we will continue. Last week we talked about a very long hadith, and we brought a couple of hadith supports the hadith and some stories of this long hadith. But inshallah, this time we will have inshallah two short hadith, and one of them we already have did it before in one of the pages that we already discussed about it. We discussed about being dutiful to the parents as long as that there's not internal disobedience. We discussed about last week, and it was such a long hadith discussing about so many things, very important stuff, and it was about nine things that we should not do, and those nine things are not only the ones that we should not do. These are just some of the things that we should not do, or some of the things that we should stay away from. Inshallah, we will continue our next hadith. So as I was explaining last week, for those of you who have not been there, it was very important to know about the nine things. But when the Prophet ﷺ says that nine or three or seven or a number does not limit to that the advice, but it goes more than that. There could be more than a lot of ways that the Prophet ﷺ would give us advice. A lot of other advices that you would see, especially for us doing this kitab, inshallah. حدثنا محمد ابن كثير قال حدثنا سفيان عن عطاء ابن سائب عن أبيه عن عبد الله ابن عمرو قال جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال جئتك قال جئت أبايعك على هجرة وتركت أبوي يبكيان قال ارجع إليهما فأضحكما كما أبكيتهما. That hadith, actually we discussed before. That was hadith 13. حدثنا أبو نعيم. We did حدثنا سفيان عن عطاء. This is a repeated hadith in this book of Imam Bukhari, rahimahullah. So he said, عن عبد الله بن عم قال جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. A man came to the Prophet of Allah, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, أبايعك على هجرة. I've came to you to make a pledge that will do a hijra, meaning that I came here to make a bay'ah, to make a hijra, a pledge to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَتَرَكْتُ أَبْوَيَّ يَبْكِيَان. And I have left my parents, أَبْوَيَّ يَبْكِيَان, and I have left my parents, يَبْكِيَان, crying, with tears coming out of their eyes. And they were really sad that he have to leave them. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told that man, "Irji' ilayhima." Go back to them. فَأَضْحِكْهُمَا كَمَا أَبْكَيْتَهُمَا. Go and make them laugh, meaning that make them happy how you made them sad, because they were crying when he left his parents. So this shows us that it's very important that today you find a lot of young people leave the country or leave their places without even asking their parents, without even consulting with their parents. They disappear. They disappear to somewhere where nobody knows. They just disappear. And our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching us here how important it is for the parents to make them happy, and at the same time to ask them for forgiveness. And at the same time here, we are learning that you should go back and always keep your parents happy. That was hadith 19. So now we're going to hadith 20. And these are all short hadith that today we are going to cover, inshallah. حدثنا علي ابن جعد قال أخبرنا شعبة عن حبيب عن أبي ثابت قال سمعت أبو عباس الأعمى عن عبد الله بن عمرو قال جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يريد الجهاد فقال أحي والديك؟ فقال نعم فقال فيهما جهاد. A man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This was narrated by Abdullah ibn Amr. قال جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. A man came to the Prophet of Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when someone is coming to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is coming to take advice from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to their situations. So جاء رجل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. يريد الجهاد. He wants to go and fight in the path of Allah. He wants to go jihad, and he wants to do jihad. فقال النبي, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to him, أحي والديك, are your parents alive? فقال نعم, he said yes. فقال فيهما جهاد, in them there is a jihad, meaning helping, supporting your parents, there is a jihad in it. It's a similarity to the jihad. Jihad al-nafs. وكذلك الجهاد, that to do when you go for Hajj is similarity also to jihad, because of the things that you have to go through. So all those young people who don't understand the importance of their parents, it is very important that we really need to take care of this. These two hadith are teaching us that the importance of take caring of our parents, and the importance of keeping our parents near us and making sure that they are all healthy and doing good. And this is hadith also sahih. And وَكَذَلِكَ الْحَدِيثُ الْأَوَّلِ, the first hadith is also an authentic hadith. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easier for us to follow this hadith and to come to understand the importance of parents. And we need to teach our children this hadith. We need to teach them, because if they don't understand and they don't know the importance of parents, because you saying it, they think that you're taking advantage of that. But if you teach them that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, be good to your parents. If our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, you teach them the hadith. This hadith teaches us this. And since now we covered almost 20 hadith, and these 20 hadith are teaching us the importance of parents. Because we are in the still the chapters of discussing about the parents and the importance of parents. So if you don't bring your child and he doesn't understand the importance of parents, so do not blame him later on if he takes you to the what? The shelter, or what we call it, the senior home. And then when you are 60 years old or 70 years old or 80 years old, then he takes you to the senior home and says that, you know, the government is paying for it, so you better go there. We've been paying tax for this. So you have to go to that home, and you can't live in my home because I really need to take care of things and so on. And there are many people that would take their parents and put them in the senior homes, and even if they do that, they don't even look at them. They come like the non-Muslims. They come Christmas. They say, oh, I have to come Christmas, or the days that I have break, or the times that I have break, or the times that I think I should come. You know, one time I used to work in a senior home, and this is a great experience, and you'll find lot of elders. They, you know, I asked them, when is your son or so on going to come and see you? Because the people who are taking care of you here are not people that they're here, they're getting paid and they just get out. They're here to work and that's it. But he said, oh, you know, my son might come, you know, I think this Christmas, or he might come the next Christmas, I'm not sure. He just comes sometimes every other Christmas, or sometimes he comes this Christmas, and this he brings me some kind of gift. You see how they, you know, neglected their parents. Why? Because this was not implemented in their life. And this was not shown that the importance of parents. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easier for us to have the ability to take care of our parents. And also at the same time, to make sure that they are safe, to make sure that they are eating healthy food, and the way they took care of you when you were young. Both parents, they did their part. So now what you need to do is to educate them so that they know what our Prophet ﷺ is to do, that our deen is not only coming to the masjid, we pray salah, you put them into madrasa, and then that's it. No, you have to come and sit down with them and say, my child,